first you have to make a template for your little lantern, depending on how big you want it. Then you make it in an hexagonal shape, so that it will fit the design that you have chosen. It's not so easy to make this. You can see I make a circle and then a triangle and then a triangle more, and after that I just cut it out with a sharp knife. Yeah, and here you can see the final shape and the markings are made for where the sticks are going to be. Yeah, and after transferring the templates to some wood, I drill out the holes where the small sticks are going to be. And of course, all in all, 6 small holes in the top and the bottom. Then I cut up the pieces, the small sticks I'm going to use. And again, depending on how big you want the lantern to be. So be careful that the sticks are equal in length. I used MDF wood for the top and the bottom, and pine wood for the sticks. And here you can see it's all, including the little holder for the candle. Then I glue it together with some special wood glue and made sure that every thick stick had the same position and the length, so that the lantern will be equal. And here I glue on the stick for the candle holder. In a moment you'll see how it works. It has to be tight there. And remove all the glue. And then it fits down there, you can see. And the candle holder, I'll secure it that later. And this is how it works. And pull it up and down. Very easy. And then I have to mount it, the top, including the candle holder stick. That's why there's a little hole in the top. You have to make sure that is. And now you can see how it functions. Yeah, very nice. Up, down. And now how you make the screen. You buy some chewing bones for dogs. I used the brown ones, they also came in white. After about 8 to 10 hours they have soaked in water, I take them up and you can see they are very soft now. And make some templates for the screen. I made 3 because I had to make 3 out of this rawhide I bought. Just put it on and cut it out. It's not so easy. It has to be a very sharp knife. And then I mark the sides where the sewing is going to be. I used a felt pen and an awl to make the holes. There's to be small holes. And after that I begin sewing it together with some waxed linen thread. It's the same thread I'm using for my leatherworks. And again, be careful not to rip it in part apart. So gently sew it together And I choose to use cross stitching, as I also use on my leather works. Just have patience and make the stitching nice and fine. And here I have put the three together before I close it, so it's going to be a round shape. Yeah, and I put in this these small sticks so that if the screen will shrink, it won't hurt the frame of the lantern. And that was actually a very good idea, because this material, the rawhide, actually shrinked a lot more than I have expected. As you can see later, how much. But it's easy to pull it over the frame now, and you can finish it up. I recommend you to make your screen a little bit larger than I have done, at least higher, so that it fits the lantern better when it's dried up. Then you have to let it rest for about 5 to 6 hours, maybe during the night, in a warm place, and the lantern will be finished. Here you can see it. I pulled this candle holder up, put in the candle, and lighting it. Then push it down. Now I'm turning off the light so you can see it in my workshop. It's very cozy, you have a nice light. Hope you find this little demonstration interesting. And again, as I used in the first lantern project, I bought some dog bones and let them soak in water for some hours, 10 to 12 hours. And when they are soaked, they are very soft. You can see here. And it's rawhide, so they are very easy to work with once they have been soaked in water. I decided to make another design. I thought I would make one that was more easy to make. So I started measuring a bottle. I had an idea how big it should be, 24 centimeters. And I just found out that I had enough there. And then I made a template. I think templates are very important to make, because then you have, you can better judge if you are doing the right way, I think. So a template for both making these lanterns and leatherworks. And then I layer the template over the rawhide and cut it out with my knife. Yeah, this time I only make one, that I only have to sew it once. So I start making the markings where the stitches are going to be, and I used an old template. There's 1 centimeter spacing between the markings, the holes. And after that, just punch the holes with this awl. And then I begin sawing it together. It is the exactly the same way when I'm doing my leather works. I use cross stitching. It's very important to make it right at the beginning. You can see here, first the one thread and then the other one. So it makes a cross. And again, it can be a little bit difficult on this rawhide because it can be very thick. So, but here you can see a cross stitching, and then I take one of the threads and put it into the one that came out, the other one. I hope you can see it here, the technique. And again, on the outside, they are crossed, and on the inside, they are not crossed. They are straight. And then at the end, make sure you have a lot of thread. sometime I have I don't have enough, so it's a little bit difficult, but I finally got it with a knot. So here you are. Yeah. And then I took my bottle and I came some baking paper on it. I thought it would be easier to get it off. And now I'm going to make the holder or the stand for the lantern. And first I make one here and approximately the same diameter as the bottle, of course. You see here the first one, just sand it, make it a little bit smoother. So that it would look nice. And then I wanted to make it as the other one, I can make a candle inside it. So I changed this, the big one to a smaller one. And then I took the same piece of wood and drilled it out. Like this. My idea was that I would only need to make one of these, so you can see. Yeah. And my design was to make a bended wooden a willow branch. I'll show you that later. I had to measure it how big the underlayer should be. Here, I just used the coin that I had to make the shape. And again, very important to make a template, so you know what you're doing. And then I just had to cut it out and see if it had the right dimension. Yeah. There's a stick is going to be both sides. Then I transfer that to a piece of wood again. I use MDF wood. I don't know if that's called in your country, but it's great to work in. And then I cut it out and sandpaper it again. The finish is very important for me. It has to be nice to hold on, to touch. And the machines does help me do that faster. Yeah, you can see. And I just had to make the markings for the holes where the sticks are going to be. Yeah. All the way I check several times, so I'm sure that it's going to be as I want it. Then I drill the holes, approximately the same dimension as the willow branch that I've chosen to use. Yeah. Again, check. Yeah. It fits nicely. Then the willow branch. You can see I'm measuring how much space there is between the two holes and marking it up on this board. I wanted to have a branch that I could bend, so I made a template, or I don't know, call it scabalon, that I could bend it around. And this will show you what I did. I tried it a couple of times before, so I knew that this would work. Yeah. Again, checking the fish. Then I use some nails. I found out during the process that the nails shouldn't have any heads on, so I used some that I cut off. But the first two here, you can see, had no heads on. And again, checking. Yeah. You can see here a nail with a head on. I removed all the heads so that the stick could come down and up without any problems. And then I tried to bend it first. Yeah, and I found out using a blowtorch or heating pistol, we call it here in Denmark, I could soften the wood and finally get it bended without it was breaking. And now you can see it's attached, and then I just had to secure it and let it dry. And I let it dry in a warm place for about 2 days. Now I was finished and I thought, well, I could just take this rawhide off, but it was stuck very firm, so I couldn't remove it. I had to destroy the bottle. And I had another problem because the rawhide didn't stay in shape, so I have to make these two out of wood so that it could space the, you can see here, I put them inside. So that made it a little bit difficult, more difficult to build this lantern. But I succeeded. You can see here. And these two rings are, of course, holding the rawhide in the right place. Now, after 2 days, and I color that wood, it's time for putting it together. And as you can see here, after drying, it stays there, but I used a rubber band, so it wouldn't move when I was working on it. Then I just had to find how big I want it to be, how high. So I'm figuring out approximately there. Checking. And marking where. And for securing it, I did this. I used some wedges. First I make a little cut at the ends and made some small wedges. And also put a little glue on, just to be safe. And then hammer it down. Both ends. And after that, I cut them off with a little saw and have to apply some paint again. It's actually the same paint that I use for my leatherworks. Leather color. Yeah. As you can see, I made such a little thing at the chop out of iron. I thought it would be great to have it on so it could keep the screen in place, but you don't need to use that. You don't need to make such one, but because the screen are actually holding in very nicely. And then I can put in the candle and light it up. Yeah, and then I have a finished lantern. Hope you like. With the other tools, I bought some chewing bones from dogs and let them soak in water for about 10 to 12 hours. And then I had a pot. Flower pots, I would use some as a template, as a form. I'll show you here how I made my templates. Just put a piece of paper or cardboard around it, secure it with tape, and then you decide how big you want your screen to be. I use this wooden block so that the size will be equal all the way around. Just make two. Like this. Yeah. And then I make one of these to make it a straight line. This is very important. Yeah, and then you have it. And just take it off and cut it out with a scissor. And the reason why I used a conical form shape was because the bottle. I couldn't get it off, so I thought, well, conical shape, I can always remove it without any problems there. This way, just be careful. And when you're finished, you can remove the extra paper you have. You don't going to need that. And then you have to, first you have to check, of course, check again. And I chose to make it in three sections. So I had to find a way I could divide this template up in three sections. First I measure it, and then, again, very important to do it right. And then I find out what is three, and just marked it three times. On both sides. And then I divided it first with the ball pen. You can see, and I number it 1, 2, and 3, so I know how it's going to be assembled. And after that, I transfer it to the raw height. And here I have the three pieces I've cut out and marked where the stitch is going to be. Just like in my other videos. And after stitching it, the three sides together, of course I have to sew the last part, so it's going to be round. And again, I use cross stitching. I think that looks nice. And then, yeah, took the pot again. See if it fits. Yeah. And then I let it dry there. And a reason why I use this conical pot is because then it won't be stuck. During the drying process, I did this a couple of times so that it got stuck on the templates or the pots. And when it was dry, I measured it around at the bottom and actually also at the top. I'm going to make my stand for it. Now you can see it's dry, but again, it doesn't keep the shape. So I had to make two rings, one at the top and one at the bottom. And that was not a part of my plan, but I had to do that. Here you can see they are glued in and colored with my leather dye. And then I made a platform for it. Yeah. And here you can see the platform is finished. And I have three holes for the sticks and this arrangement, so I can put the candle in here, yeah, and just secure it down here, like I showed in my video. And then I just had to get my sticks, my branches from willow, and adjust them so they could fit down in the holes. And I glue them onto the platform. And now I just put the tree on. Of course, it fits nicely. And yeah, put them together at the top. And I used natural cordage to bind them together. tight, of course. Yeah, and at the first I used a little, you see a little ball, a little pearl here, but I changed that for the Thor's hammer. And now I'm going to try to light it up for the first time using a candle. It's already very exciting to the first time to see how the lamp, the lantern is performing. Up there, there you are, my little lantern. I think it's a very nice little lantern. I love it very much. It's very primitive and old school. Here you can see, yeah,